The Atlanta Stoveworks Company was founded in 1889, and in 1902 they built a second foundry in Birmingham, especially for the production of hollowware and cast iron cookware to supplement their stoves, and this separate foundry was named Birmingham Stove and Range. Many of the original records from Atlanta Stoveworks have been lost, especially because the original factory burned down in 1915 and was rebuilt. They officially began producing their Red Mountain series of cast iron pans in 1930, but it seems likely they were making these cast iron pans even before they were named Red Mountain. The Red Mountain series of cast iron pans had very few markings, but they can be easily recognized in several ways. They had a prominent heat ring around the bottom for fitting into a wood-burning stove, and unlike Lodge cast iron, this was a solid heat ring with no notches. They didn't mark their name on these pans, and the only identification marks were a large letter and a number. On this pan here, the number 8 indicates it's a size 8 pan. The letter C is a mold marker, and it could be lettered A through Z. Of course, the most famous and obvious marking on a pan from BS&R was the shape of the handle, with this very obvious ridge on the underside and the teardrop-shaped hanging hole. They actually trademarked this design, and the pans for the entire life of the company were made with this handle, though they did a few variations in their later days. Meanwhile, BS&R also made cast iron Dutch ovens for use in the kitchen, and these pots had a smooth bottom without a heat ring. The marking on the bottom was identical to their skillets, as we see with this Dutch oven with the size number 8 and mold letter A. BS&R was also the only major manufacturer to make their Dutch ovens with a pour spout on one end. This meant the lids could fit on both the Dutch ovens and the skillets. The lids of these Dutch ovens were unique, as they had these dimples on the underside instead of spikes or rings seen in lids from other companies. Just as important, BS&R pans had a unique size, and their lids would not fit the pans from any other company. Even today, it's not difficult to find Red Mountain series pans in the hunt for vintage cast iron at flea markets, antique malls, and other places. But because these pans don't have a maker's mark on them, many people don't know who made them. The earliest known Red Mountain pans are described by collectors as handwritten pans because they're marked with size numbers and ID numbers that look as though they were written by hand. These would have been inscribed into the patterns that were used to make the cast iron molds, and there are variations in the way they were inscribed. Obviously, this was because they were producing a disposable product, and these cheap frying pans didn't mean very much to marketers, so this was done in the least expensive way. Also during this time, BS&R produced a series of pans that were marked with an S, and they were very slightly smaller in size than their standard cast iron skillets. BS&R collectors today identify this as the S series of pans, and it's thought they were made from the 1930s to the 1940s. The S series was identified by BS&R collectors on Facebook, and without their observations, we wouldn't have known the S series existed at all. Of course, now eBay is having a field day with sellers selling this rare series of pans at ridiculous prices. BS&R finally standardized the writing of the size numbers on their pans, and they made pans with this easily identifiable font style from the late 1930s, or perhaps 1940s, until the 1960s when they began automated production. Also in their early days, BS&R produced a series of outdoor cookware, including a cast iron spider skillet and lid that they made all the way to the 1980s. Antique vendors usually assume any cast iron spider at all was made in the 19th century, and if you come across a pan like this, it could be as much as 100 years younger than what the seller says it's dated to. The Red Mountain series of outdoor pans had a large size number on the bottom and the lid, and they did not have a gate mark that you see on spider skillets from the 1800s. These camp spiders are rare, but not impossible to find. But their original camp ovens are extremely rare, and I've only seen a few photos of them on the internet. They had vertical ears designed like older cast iron cauldrons rather than the horizontal hanging handles we see in modern day camp ovens. In fact, I have a cast iron lid from the Red Mountain series that has this unusual size number of 13 inches. and I'd love to come across a camp oven or spider that fits this lid. I may never find one of those for the rest of my life, but you never know, and that's why they call it a treasure hunt. It was also at this time BS&R began marketing their Sportsman grill, plus the oval fish fryer pan that was made to be used on this grill. This grill was originally made as a sad iron heater for these cast iron irons, but their marketing division had the idea to market this as a grill for cooking food, and it was a success, so much that they redesigned the grill slightly with three legs instead of four, and they continued to sell it for the rest of the lifespan of their company. The earlier series of oval fryer pans had a rectangular handle, and many of these fryers had a Sportsman logo on the underside of the handle, though the oldest of these fryers didn't have this logo. And this still doesn't cover all of the different cast iron pans made by BS&R during their Red Mountain days, including stew pots for the stovetop, and even these cornstick pans, which can be identified by the shape of the handle. The cornstick pan had a simple mark on the back indicating the number of cornsticks on the pan, which was always 7, and a letter to identify one of 4 different designs for this pan. All of the cornstick pans produced in the Red Mountain series had hand-scribed marks, and this wasn't standardized until the 1960s.